Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 8 of solving an equation containing a radical. And in part 7, I solved this equation by keeping it the way it was and squaring both sides, thereby isolating the radical on the right. And in this video, I'm going to isolate the radical on the left by subtracting one from both sides. All right, so here's the problem. So if I want to isolate this square root, the square root of negative 3x plus 16, I'm going to have to subtract one from both sides, which will give me square root of negative 3x plus 16 equals square root of negative 4x plus 25 minus 1. So the left side is isolated, which is the reason we want to isolate it is because when we square a square root, we get what's inside of it. So on the left side, when I square the square root of negative 3x plus 16, I just get what's underneath the square root, which is the negative 3x plus 16. Now on the right side, you're squaring a binomial. So I'm going to show all the steps here. That's the square root of negative 4x plus 25 minus 1 times the square root of negative 4x plus 25 minus 1. So the left side, nothing to do, just copy it down. On the right side, I'm squaring. Actually, no, I'm going to use the FOIL method here. You don't have to do this step here. You can just square a binomial at this step if you know how to do that, which of course you should. But some people find it easier to write it out. So when I multiply the first term times the first term, I've got the square root of the same thing, so I'm going to get what's inside, which is just negative 4x plus 25. My outer term will be this negative 1 times that square root, so I've got a minus 1 or a minus square root of negative 4x plus 25. If you want, you could put minus 1 in front of the square root. And then the inner term will be the same thing, a minus 1 square root of 4x minus 25. And I'm running out of room here, so let's see, how about if I move this slightly in? Sorry, it's so small. And then I've got negative 1 times negative 1, which is plus 1. So on the right-hand side, I'm just going to combine my like terms. So on the left, I have negative 3x plus 16. Now on the right side, I've got the negative 4x. And see, I've got the 25 and the plus 1. That's 26. And then these two radicals, I've got a negative 1 and another negative 1. So I got negative 2 square roots of negative 4x plus 25. All right, so I've simplified the right-hand side. Now I just want to isolate this square root, right? This term, this negative 2 square roots of negative 4x plus 25. So I've got to add 4x minus 26 to both sides. So add 4x minus 26 to both sides. And that gives me x minus 10 equals negative 2 square root of negative 4x plus 25. Now, you could divide both sides by this coefficient of negative 2, but that makes it complicated with fractions. So at this point, we've isolated the term that has the square root, so let's square both sides again. So we square each side of the equation. And all right, so we have an x minus 10 quantity squared. Again, you could just use the formula for squaring a binomial. X minus 10 times x minus 10. I'm just going to show it out, although I'm sure some of you go right to the answer without having to do this. And on the right-hand side, we're squaring the negative 2, right? And we're also squaring the square root of negative 4x plus 25. So on the left-hand side, FOIL method, x squared minus 10x minus 10x plus 100. On the right-hand side, a negative 2, when you square it, is positive 4, because it's negative 2 times negative 2. And that gets multiplied by this. Well, when you square a square root, you get what's underneath the square root sign. So you get to multiply that by a negative 4x plus 25. So on the left-hand side, to simplify it, I just combine my like terms. X squared minus 20x plus 100. And on the right side, we do the distributive property. Negative 16x plus 100. So we've simplified both sides. We don't have any more square roots. And I see I have an x squared term. So that signifies I have a quadratic. When you have a quadratic, you set it equal to 0. So we're nearing the finish line again. We want to add 16x minus 100 to both sides. So I have x squared minus 4x equals 0. Factor it. So we have x equals 0, or x minus 4 equals 0, which means x equals 4. So my two solutions look to be 0 and 4. Now remember, you have to check each solution in the original. In the previous video, part 7, I already checked it, so I'm not going to go through all the steps again here, but I'm going to show you again what the checks look like, and this is the correct solution. It does check. So here are the steps. When I checked x equals 0, found out that that was a solution, so that was definitely a solution that checked. And then here's when I checked x equals 4 into the original, and it checked. So that means the solution to this problem is both numbers are solutions, 0 and 4. So here's the solution, both 0 and 4. You might try this again on your own. This is a little bit tricky, problem. It's got these negative signs in it, etc. It makes it a little more complicated. But if you can do this problem, hopefully you can do any other one.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.